Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. I'm Ohima, and today we're gonna be recording a skincare slash makeup routine. We have been in quarantine, we have been on lockdown, so our normal everyday routines have, you know, well, at least for me, have kind of been thrown in the bin. You know, since I'm working from home, I don't really have the opportunity to get up, put on makeup, do my hair, fix my eyebrows, fix my lashes. I literally just roll out of bed and get right to it. So it's been a while since I've dolled up or I've done any kind of makeup or even gotten dressed up, because the only place I'm going is to the grocery store and I don't have time to be putting on makeup for that. But today's video is, you know, just to show you how to take care of your skin, you know, while you're still on lockdown. Just because we're not going anywhere doesn't mean that our skin shouldn't be glowing and popping and flourishing. So, and you know, we could do this in preparation of getting ready to go back outside and slay. Hopefully, you know, we'll be back outside with each other, loving on each other, going to events and stuff like that. And you wanna make sure that underneath your makeup, your skin is popping too. So stay tuned, and I hope you guys enjoy the video. Okay, you guys, so let's get started with our skincare routine. So what you wanna do is, I've already washed my face off camera, but the first step that you wanna do is to wash your face with whatever soap you like or whatever soap that you're using for your type of skin condition. For me right now, let me see, I don't know if you can see, like, I have like a little pimple here. I have like little dark spots, I think, but they kind of blend in with some of my freckles. So sometimes I don't know if it's the dark spot or if it's the freckles. But one major issue that I have with my skin, or that I dislike about my skin, is I feel like I have large pores. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it in this video, but I know they're there. I normally use apricot scrub, which is like an exfoliator, but I try to not use that as much because I don't always want to be like scrubbing away, or, you know, peeling away the good stuff that's meant to be on my skin. So I'm not using that right now. I am using a bar soap. I think it's by Shea Moisture, but just using a bar soap, you know, I just rub that on my face, you know, wash that on my face. Sometimes I do use my face brush to wash, or sometimes I just, you know, use my hand, wash it with warm or cool water. So this is for after you've washed your face with the soap of your choice, with the routine of your choice. I initially bought this for my hair, this mask. It is the Health and Beauty Aztec Secret Indian Healing Clay. So this is the bentonite clay. So this is what it looks like on the inside. So I initially bought this as a detox mask for my hair, but it is also good for the skin. So I'm also using this as a mask once a week on my skin. So what I normally do, you just wanna make an amount that that's gonna be enough for your face so that you don't end up wasting the clay. So I use this, and you can use like a tea, if you're doing just enough for your face, just for you to use that mask for the day, you can use like a teaspoon of this, or maybe 2 teaspoons of this, a teaspoon of apple cider vinegar, a teaspoon of tea tree oil, and this is my black seed oil. So I just got this. My sister actually ordered this for me in Texas and sent it to me. So I've heard a lot of good things about it. This is my first time trying it on the skin. The other times that I've tried it, it was for like, I ingested it for like health reasons, but it's good for health, you know, for your insides, for your immunity. I believe it aids in weight loss as well too, and it's good for the skin. I have the oil. I'm using the oil version for my skin, and then I do have the, what was it called? The powder version as well. The powder version, I just put that in my smoothie, but right now we're doing this for skin. So you just wanna, you know, take that, you know, mix it in a bowl. You may need to add some water to the mixture, because what I've noticed is that when you add the apple cider vinegar to the clay, it kind of like like fizzles, like almost fizzles it away. So it may, the amount of it may not come out to a lot. So maybe just to get that thickness or consistency that you want, you might wanna add water to it. Now I already have some pre-made from the last time I used the mask. Clearly I made too much and I didn't wanna throw it away. So I just preserved mine in the fridge. Like I just, you know, wrapped it with a plastic wrap and preserved it in the fridge. So I've already washed my face. So, and I'm gonna use one of my brushes. When you make this mask, you want to, everything that you use to make it, the utensils that you put it in, that you mix it with, you want to make sure it's plastic. Anything metal will, from what I've heard, it'll cancel out the clay. I don't know why. I didn't read on it, but I'm just telling y'all what I learned. So, you know, use a plastic utensil to mix it and, you know, mix it inside a plastic bowl. So I'm going to use a makeup brush to apply it to my skin. Oh my God. I'm surprised that the mask still has the same consistency when I first made it. So I'm just gonna apply it to my skin, to my whole face, like so. And it doesn't smell too bad, so. Make sure I get it on my forehead too. You know, you just want to put enough, or, you know, I just always put it on until I get a nice coverage to my liking, so. And you know, if there's just a problem area that you want to deal with, you could just put it on that area, you know? But I like to put it on my whole face. I like to feel like I'm in a spa, so. So yeah, and that's it. So you want to cover your whole face evenly with the mask, and then you want to wait till it dries. I would say the last time I wore this mask, maybe it took me about, I want to say no more than 20 minutes. Or at least no more than 30 minutes before it completely dries. You wanna wait till it completely dries, wash it off with warm water. Once you wash it off of your face, rinse your face with cool water for those of you who have large pores, to close those pores back up. So I'm going to go off camera, wait for this to dry, wash my face, and then I'll come back and we will get into the remainder of the skincare routine / makeup routine. Okay guys, so I am back. My skin is washed. I ate off camera. This YouTube thing, you know, it's a lot of work. So you gotta fuel your body, you know, put nutrients in there. No, I hadn't eaten all day. So I was just like, well, let me, you know, take advantage and eat off camera too. So the mask, I would say no more than maximum, just depending on the consistency that you made, but the consistency is not too thick where it needs a whole lot of drying time. So I would say maximum 10 minutes. It should all be dry and you should be good to wash it off. So after I wash the mask off of my face, and even after, because the mask is not always in my routine. Remember I said if you're gonna do the mask, it's something that you should do probably once a week. So after the mask, or after you have washed your face with your method of choice and soap of choice, you need like a serum. Now I got this serum, which is the Advanced Clinicals Collagen Serum. It says instant plumping, dual formula, instantly plump skin for a flash radiance, pure collagen and soy extracts lift aging complexions, firming algae extract supports skin tone. So what did I see on this that made me buy it? The soy extract that's in here targets sagging, loss of elasticity and facial lines. The glycerin increases hydration for a dewy glow. The collagen plumps and locks in essential moisture. What else did I see on this? I just thought that it would be a really good serum to use on my skin. The serum comes like this, and it has the little suction tube I don't know what you call it. So I just normally take some and make sure I get a good amount in there. And then I normally just drip on my forehead, drip on that side, drip on that side, and I just kind of like rub it, like make sure like to spread it evenly around the face. So yeah, you want to put that on, let it dry. And then after you do that, I'm gonna close this back. There was one I was using before. It came like this. It was like a serum like this as well too. If I find it, I'll let you guys know. But I got this particular one from Walmart. It was $4.82, so about $5. I got it from Walmart in their skincare section. Sometimes what I've experienced with Walmart, like certain products or certain skincare products you'll go there for, you'll see it once and then you may not see it again. I was able to see this on their website, so if you do want to order it online, you can. I'll put the description in the link below so that you guys can click on it if this is something that you're interested in or think that it will work well for your skin. So this was $5. So after the serum dries on my face, what was the directions? The directions are to allow several minutes for the serum to absorb. So I'm just gonna talk to you for those several minutes. I follow up with this cream. This is the Tea Time White Tea Day Cream. And this is from Earth to Skin. This is also something that I got at Walmart. It was $8.94. This says it's with hyaluronic acid. Hopefully I'm saying that right. Don't judge me. But the reason why I got this is what it says on there. The pore refining. Remember I told you guys that I'm having an issue with my pores. I'm trying to shrink those babies. So that is the reason why I got this bad boy here. So after your serum dries, which I think, is okay. What I've noticed with the serum is that once it dries, like my skin just looks like this. It looks dewy. It looks, I don't want to say oily, but it looks like I applied something to it. This is the cream. This is what it looks like outside of the box. That's the inside. So I normally just take... dab it there, dab it there, ooh, a little bit more, dab it here, dab it here. And this is just to, moisturize your face. Woo, pick that up later, after the fact, Can't be out here with an ashy face. So, I just rub that into the skin, like so. And there. You have it. See, this is me. This is my natural skin, on a good day. I don't really have like bad breakouts or anything like that. I probably get like maybe one or two period pimples or whatever, stuff like that. So yeah, so that's it. That's all you really need to do to, at least for me, that is all I do for my skincare. Routine. I may do other extra special stuff if I get a reaction to something or my skin is just like really acting up, but for the most part that's it. So we're gonna jump into the makeup routine, or just this makeup look. I'm gonna do my makeup. I'm gonna probably go bike riding with Bae after this or whatever. I don't normally wear makeup to go bike riding, but I wanted to get dolled up today. So today's makeup look is going to be featuring one of my favorite at the moment, because I'm really liking them right now. I just recently started buying some of their products. Juvia's Place. Their eyeshadow is so pigmented. I just had to have some of my own, some palettes of my own. So I recently just got this palette. And then the first time I ordered these two palettes. So this one is the Nubian, this green palette. And let me show you what the inside looks like. I'm gonna take the little plastic out. I still use my little plastic to protect my eyeshadow. So that's the inside of that. This is the Nubian 3 Coral, this one. Open that up, that's the inside of that. And then the other one is the Warrior 2. So open that up. And that's the inside of that. So we're gonna be using these for our eyeshadow look. I don't know exactly what we're creating today. I'm just gonna go with the flow. It's not gonna be something too extravagant because again, I'm only going bike riding. And then I have some highlighter from them. This is the Loose Highlighter Nefertiti. So we're gonna be using this today as well. So with your makeup, you want to start with a primer, which is what I'm gonna do here. And then this type of primer that I got is specifically for minimizing pores. The worst thing that can happen is when you put makeup on and your pores are showing through. I've made a mistake before where I didn't prime the skin before putting on makeup. And when I put my highlighter on, it draws more attention. Like the highlight, you know, highlighter is gonna make something to stand out, to pop out. So it was really making the fact that I had large pores stand out in. That one cool. So I'm just gonna rub that in like so. Now, after you rub that in, I'm gonna go ahead and start with the eyebrows. I always start with my eyebrows first. So normally you just wanna use like a brush or eyebrow comb just to, you know, kind of comb it out. Now I have I naturally have thick and long eyebrows, but I have done some damage. I think they're just starting to grow back too. I've done some damage to these eyebrows during Corona period because, you know, everything is closed. So normally where I get my eyebrows done is also closed and, you know, it's been struggle bunny over here. So I have started using this, you know, the eyebrow trimmer, shaper or whatever to try to kind of clean it up. And, you know, you get to cleaning, you know, one side and, you know, maybe you probably chop off more than what you're supposed to. And then you're trying to even it out and I just feel like my eyebrows are not talking to each other right now. They're not even sisters. Like, they're not even friends right now. Like, they're feuding. So, but, you know, at least I still have eyebrow there. You know, something we could work with. So, I'm gonna use my eyebrow pencil. I normally just kind of fill in the spaces that kind of look like they have gaps. I don't draw it on from start to finish. I just kind of fill in places like where the hair looks sparse to me. So now that I've filled in my eyebrows, I'm gonna go ahead with my concealer. And I normally just take a brush and I'll clean it up. So normally what I do after is once I've moved most of the concealer with the brush, I normally take like one of these spongy things and like just try to dab away the excess concealer. So after you do that, Some people normally like to do like maybe their eyeshadow next, just because, you know, if you do your eyeshadow first and then you put your foundation, then you can clear away the fallout that you'll get from your makeup, which is what I think I'm gonna do. So I think on my eyelid, I'm just gonna put a little more primer. I think that's what I'll use instead today. Let me try, because I normally use concealer. So let me try the primer on my eyelid instead and see if I like the outcome of that better. Okay, so maybe probably use this to pat it on. That still has some concealer on it, but that's okay. Okay, so I think I'm probably gonna go for like a neutral, natural kind of glam today. So I'm just gonna use one of my random palettes that I have, and I'm going to start with this color in the crease. I'm gonna go ahead and pop one of my darker browns into it. Which one do I wanna use? It's gonna be from the Juvia's place. So I think I'm gonna go ahead with this color, but not too much of it, because I don't want it to start coming out too dark. I'm just gonna kind of put that in the corner here. And then what I normally do is I normally go back in with that crease color, just to make sure that crease color still pops. And then I'll just use some dust on my eyelids. And then after I get that on there, I think I want to use try to pop a lighter brown, which is going to be this color. You can see that. And you want to use an eyeshadow brush that has this tip when you're packing it onto your lid here. Okay, so now that we have done that part, what we're gonna do next is the tear duct. So I normally try to use like one of these brushes, or I normally use a Q-tip to get in the corner here to put makeup in there. So I'm gonna be using a color from this palette. I'm gonna start with this brush though. I'm gonna be using this color right here. And I'm just gonna go right in the corner of my eye. And do what you gotta do to get into the tear duct, girls. And then just go back in and clean it up. So then now I'm gonna go in and do my foundation. So I'm gonna be using the Maybelline Fit Me Dewy and Smooth Foundation in the color 375. So you wanna take your handy dandy beauty blender and you wanna get some on there. Then after you've gotten your foundation on, you want to go ahead and conceal. So then once I'm done with that, I try to contour. At least I try to. It doesn't always work out the way that I want it to work out. This is the darkest shade of like any kind of concealer or contour color that I've been able to find. Then I like to go underneath that contour. Then I normally go in with translucent powder, but for some reason I can't find mine. So I just use like my compact pressed powder just to kind of blend out everything that I did a little more. Okay, so we're gonna come back for that darker shade. And you wanna make sure you blend it in enough and get rid of like the harsh lines. And so after we done that, I mean, the next thing that you can go into are your lashes. Just gonna plop some onto my top and bottom. Not too much on the top though, cause I will apply some falsies. Okay, so now we want to go back into that tear duct. And then you can use like, if you make a mess of it, you could just use, you know, a Q-tip to clean it up a little.
Download exclusives from hitsth.com.
Just go back in like with my compact. Go back in with my pressed powder compact, you know, just to clean up any fallouts or anything like that. And then once we're done with there, you know, you want to put your lashes on. I'm trying to decide. I think I'll probably go with these Beauty Supply lashes. Get your tweezers. I just wanna put some glue on your eyelashes. Kinda let it dry off or get tacky a little bit. once I've done that, I'm just gonna go ahead and spray with some setting spray. Let that dry. Then while we're letting that dry, I'm gonna go ahead and do my lip. So I'm just gonna take a eyebrow pencil or lip pencil. So once I do that, I'm just gonna rub it in a little bit. And then I'm gonna put some lip gloss on. And then put some lip gloss on top of it, some clear lip gloss. And then last but not least, I'm gonna put on some eyeliner. So now we've got our eyeliner on, and then last but not least, your highlighter, so. And I'm gonna take a little and put it on my nose. And I'll go back in, touch up everywhere else. Natural makeup glam is done. You know, not too much. Still look like a cute little, you know, black little Barbie. But just something to, you know, go out with. You know, you can use this look for, well, I don't know what you could use it for right now because ain't nobody going nowhere right now. But, you know, if you're just been feeling in the funk, you know, because you've been stuck in the house and, you know, just want to feel good, this is a look that you can do. So, I'm gonna do my baby hairs, style and flip my hair, you know, and I'll be back. So, this is the finished look, guys. So, you know, I got my Princess Jasmine, Nubian Queen, Black Barbie, you know, kind of thing going on. So, you can use this look to spice things up at home with bae if you're just feeling down and you just want to get dolled up because we've been stuck in the house too long. Even if you want to wear this look to the grocery store because that's about the only place that we could go right about now. Or if you just want to practice this look until outside opens back up and, you know, this look could be your first sleigh. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. I hope you like the finished look. I like the finished look. It's very clean, very neat, very neutral, not too much going on. You know, got your Black Queen vibes going on. So, that's it. I want to thank you guys for watching. Thank you for tuning into my channel. I hope you like, subscribe, turn on your notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Ohima, O-H-E-M-A-A, Afia, A-F-I-A, _. So, you know, that way you can see my page, you can see my pictures, you can see my posts. So, I hope you guys enjoy. Love you guys.